Hello,
I'm Nikias Klohr, Head of R&D here at Result, and in this video I would like to do a little deep dive about the display that we're using in our Ubidium timing system. So we've got this question quite often in the last year. Why are we using this kind of display? Aren't there better displays available out there? I mean, typically you are used from your, for example, cell phone, from your smartphone, high resolution, color, OLED, all kinds of displays, which bring you sharp HD quality, all this stuff. And I can tell you, actually, the hardware that we have in the system would be able to actually run an HDMI interface and run HD content, and you could even watch a video on it if you wanted to. But this is not typically what you need as a timekeeper on an event. And this is why we chose to go a different route and not use a display that would actually be easier to get and go for a custom display specifically manufactured for us. And I would like to tell you some details about it and explain to you why we did it. The number one reason is that you want to be able to read the display in all circumstances, may it be temperatures or different lighting situations. And for temperatures, it's already pretty important that we do have customers who use this in the deepest winter, and we also have customers using this in Australian outback. So we have a huge temperature range to cover. And the display that we're using here is specified from minus 20 to plus 60 degrees Celsius for perfect readability, but it even is readable at minus 20 and plus 80 degrees Celsius, which is more than enough for all events that we have come across so far. The other question is, how well is it readable outdoors? And here the important factor is that with typical normal display technologies, you always have to fight the sun with brightness. And brightness means energy consumption. And we don't want to go that route because we want to have highest battery life and still be able to read the display during the event at all times, not having to turn it on in some way. So what we did here is we chose a transreflective display, meaning actually on the back of this display, there is a foil which lets light through from the back if we turn on the backlight, but also acts like a mirror when it's subjected to sunlight. So as soon as sunlight comes through, actually the back of the display reflects the sunlight, and the display gets even more readable the brighter it is, without us wasting any energy for backlights. So that's the first thing. And transreflective can only really be done with black and white LCDs like we have here. So here we are with an LCD. Now, if you look at this display here, actually there are two connectors, one on the bottom and one at the top. And why is this? Actually, this display is two displays. There are two display controllers in it, one for the upper half and one for the lower half. You could ask, okay, why is this important? You could actually do this with one controller, no problem, but you would not get the low temperature performance, because the low temperature performance is defined by the length of the actual cable going through the pixel to the pixel on the display. And you don't want it to be too long, because then you will lose contrast at low temperatures. And this is why we chose to actually go for a double display. This is two displays in one, to be able to do the low temperature performance. The other thing is that the configuration of how the display is actually driven is specifically designed for our application. And actually we configured it in our thermal chambers so that it doesn't turn black when it's very hot and it doesn't freeze when it's very cold. Also, the liquid LCD, the crystal liquid inside this display, is not the typical standard LCD liquid that you would find in low-cost LCDs. And this enables us to go for the wide temperature range. Maybe one last thing that we could do, because this is a custom display, is we could choose a custom pixel size. And an important fact here is that we wanted the system and the display to be readable when you're standing in front of the system. So you don't have to move down to read it. You can actually read this display standing in front of it. And this is because of the size of the display and also the size of the pixels themselves. So we went for quite large pixels to make that possible so that you can get a quick overview of what's going on even just standing next to the system. This gives you a brief overview of why we're using this kind of display technology and why it's better actually for our purpose than the normal displays that you would find in consumer electronics everywhere, which would be easier to get and actually easier to integrate. And actually it's been quite a challenge to get this display specifically made for our purpose, to our requirements, to get the best experience to you guys out there. So thanks for watching and see you next time.